Oh no! Help! Help! Crikey! Not me!
Railways have always used coal to keep everything on the move. Thomas had once thought moving coal trucks was the worst job. With the railway listing on the stock market, moving coal was now as important as ever.
You trucks have been very good to me today.
The thinner you empty us, the better. We're thicker all with coal.
Thomas headed away from the coal mine into the open country. Thomas lay upside down with severe burns. The coal trucks were completely destroyed. A local potato farmer raised the alarm and help was soon at hand. Earl arrived bringing Jim the crane and the fat controller.
Well, I've seen some accidents in my time, but this is no accident. I'd say there's been a bombing.
Thomas was gently lifted onto the flat rail car by Jim.
With the coal mine now shut off, I'll have to ration the coal until the line is repaired. There'll be a special meeting at the sheds later.
Later that day, Earl pulled into the rail yard. Thomas was carefully placed on the tracks for repairs.
This has been a very sad day for the railways. It seems there's a mad bomber on the loose. We must do all we can to be on the lookout for suspicious characters.
The engines looked at each other.
Come on, Noel.
Well, who are you looking at?
I will issue all of you with video cameras as security devices, so use them wisely.
The engines viewed the cameras still in their boxes. Noel surveyed the stock.
Well, with all these new cameras, we can start a video club. Just look at the great features on these new cameras. Wow.
Gleaming Red Ted quickly formulated the rules stating,
I challenge all the engines to produce a video on any subject within a month. The best video will win a boiler flush.
The engines mounted their cameras and made safe for the night. But on everyone's mind was the threat of a mad bomber. Next morning saw Andy the Diesel enter the yard boasting.
So your coal supply has all dried up. It's about time you were all scrapped.
Bob replied as he was still trying to turn his camera on.
We might be old and dependent on coal, but we're survivors.
Bob and Margot carried on delivering the food supplies down their branch line. Elsewhere, Scottish John was fitting some gas bottles as an alternative fuel. His video thoughts were on this process. Chris was working on a story based on a train's last journey. Alan, the self-funded retired engine, planned a video about the town's feral cats. Wilson was always interested in how cars would race him between stations. Earl had his eyes on the skies and teamed up with Helen the helicopter. Back in the sheds, Thomas was being repaired. He also had a camera and his video was being planned.
At least I can keep an eye on Andy Diesel if I'm stuck here.
The fat controller was also keeping an eye on things.
These figures are not looking good. The share prices have taken a sudden dive since the bombing.
He moved to the turntable to chat with Andy Diesel.
I'm relying on you, Andy, to bring things back online.
I'll do that easily. You can forget about those steam engines now.
Just the diesel I wanted to see. I have a small but important job for you. Something we'll have to keep secret. Very secret.
The diesel looks at Andy and says nothing. Andy's secret plans are whispered to the black diesel.
That's my boy. I like the quiet ones. no back chat, like I get from those clapped out dinosaur steamers. Same goes for you coal trucks, clogging up every siding, serving your masters with stinking coal. What's that blue paint on your driver's cab? Have you been repairing that pesky Thomas engine? For a chap who doesn't say much, looks like you've been batting for the other side. My strongest advice to you is stick with me. I have connections in very high places, way above the fat controller. He's just a puppet who's about to lose his strings.
Two weeks had passed and the engines assembled at the rail yards. Off in the distance a storm was brewing, so all the engines packed into the sheds. Thomas was almost repaired and was being fired up to check for any boiler leaks. The fat controller made a brief announcement.
I hope you're all getting used to your new cameras. Keep up the good work.
Ted was curious about the videos.
Okay, lads. We'll have a short movie night just to see how you've progressed.
Earl was the first to show his work. The engines hissed at the first video. They had never seen the sheds from the sky before.
I put my camera in the helicopter. Hey, just have a look at this where I went. Boy, there's some tremendous shots.
A bit shaky, this.
Oh, I don't like heights. What's, why is it shaking like that? Hey, it's all wobbly. Why don't you use a tripod?
Oh, look at those sheds right down there. Wow.
An outstanding effort, Earl. Excellent titling, good composition, although some shots are a little shaky.
Bob was next, but was unable to remove the tape from his camera.
Well, you see, it's a drama. It's very good. I act in it. One of the most exciting scripts that I've ever seen.
Okay, Bob, don't give the story away. Chris, have you got something to show?
Chris's video played, and silence fell upon the shed. The lightning outside enhanced the story as the thunder broke the silence.
Now that's a video. It sends shivers through your boiler. A fine example of how old videos should be made. Alan, it's your turn. A little different. Seems like you shot the tracks, not the cats.
Wilson was next, but explained.
Well, you see, I had this accident. A car ran over my camera.
Ted seemed bemused by this and called for Scottish John. I'd like to tell you all about LP gas. It's very good to run your engine on. It's clean, but most of all, it's cheap, and that's what I like.
Yes, a solid industrial video, John. Well done all.
Then from the corner, Thomas whistled.
Ted? I have a video. Well, it's sort of an animation. Can I show it?
Animation? Well, did you use your camera, Thomas?
Is that according to the rules, Ted? I mean, are you sure about that?
Okay, I think we can stretch the rules this time.
This is the best thing I've ever seen.
I think I see something. What's that on the turntable?
Noel steamed forward, asking for a replay at reduced speed.
Come on, Noel.
There's nothing.
You've got to be joking.
I can't see it. You've got to be joking.
I didn't see any of that.
What do you see, Noel?
I think that's a bomb on the turntable.
A bomb?
Don't panic, everyone. I can get it.
Thomas steamed out of the shed. His driver placed the bomb on the running board and headed down the main line.
If I am quick, I'll save the railways from certain doom. It's no good being on the main line. I'll have to find a siding.
Thomas didn't see that the points were set to go into a work shed.
Oh no, that's 80 diesel shed. I'll never stop in time.
Andy couldn't believe his eyes.
Oh no! Help! Crikey's not me!
The next day saw Thomas once again being lifted into the shed for repairs.
Well, Thomas, you saved the railways and your video showed the bomber hard at work.
Just then, the fat controller arrived with the police.
I've heard the mystery of the bombings is solved.
That's right. Thomas had a video of the turntable while Andy Diesel was in the yard. I noticed a suspicious character lurking near his fuel tank, and we believe that character is you.
The policeman holds the fat controller.
We also noticed you manipulating the stock market, selling shares just before the first bombing and buying just after.
Right then, you're coming with me.
Thomas, your video was the key to saving the railways. Your brave actions also ridded us of that lazy diesel.
Thomas's video went on to scoop all the prizes in the video competition. It just goes to show that a little video can go a long way.